Hi everyone, I'm Cyril Becker, CTO of Alterway Cloud Consulting, a French consulting company specializing in cloud computing and in workload based on containers. I've been working in IT for 14 years and had the opportunity to work on high volumetry platforms in different sectors such as HPC, advertising, or video games. I've been using Kubernetes and Prometheus in production since 4 years. Today, I'm going to talk about Flux2 and GitOps on Capsule, the managed Kubernetes service of Scaleway. So let's start by what is GitOps. GitOps is an operation model based on Git. It is designed for continuous delivery for application and service. GitOps is built around synchronization mechanisms rather than pushing chains. It's a major difference. It allows you to improve your productivity and easily industrialize your Kubernetes cluster. It is very easy to implement and adapt perfectly to Kubernetes. It's a way of managing your infrastructure and application so that whole system is described decoratively and version controlled, most likely in a Git repository. And having also an automated process that ensures that the deployment environment matches the state specified in the repository. You can see it here. Git is a central tool between development and deployment in production. On the left, the developers skip the continuous integration cycle, but integrate now the deployment configuration. This allows you to automatically deploy and deliver service and application to the infrastructure. GitOps is focused on Git function. It allows you easy rollbacks in case of problems, audit of action and change, teamwork and collaboration on codes, and automatic self-repair in case of difference with the repository. Now let's see a classic CI/CD chain for delivering the application in Kubernetes. On the left, the developers work in a Git repository. A CI/CD tool, such as GitLab, is responsible for building the application as a Docker image and pushing it to a Docker registry. Then, the new Docker image is delivered to Kubernetes clusters by modifying the image used in the deployment. This is generally done with the powerful API from Kubernetes, which is a simple YAML or JSON post. In the new model, any direct modification of the cluster is avoided. Same for pushing change from the CI/CD tools. We are still building the Docker image with GitLab, but delivery method is now different. Now, the Kubernetes cluster himself check if there is some change to apply from the Git repository. This is done by a Kubernetes operator and tools like Argo CD or Flux. The operator syncs the state of the cluster, the Git cloud repository. If changes are detected, like a new application to deploy or a new service to deploy, the operator set up automatically this new application or service in the cluster. So we have a huge change of method because we now have a controller to check that our Kubernetes cluster is well configured against the code repository. If there is a difference, it can repair itself to return to the reference state. This is very powerful and allows you to fully master your deployment. So why GitOps is great? It's built on top of your continuous integration. You don't need to change anything. Everything works with sync automatization. It manages your delivery lifecycle. It allows you easily to roll back and doing automatic rollback. It supports also Helm and customize natively. So it's a great delivery tools for Kubernetes. Here's a common use case on Kubernetes. Deploy an ingress controller to expose web application, for example, but also including cert manager. Deploying a monitoring stack with Prometheus and Grafana. And also Istio service mesh for application observability, especially for the web application. In the GitOps model, all your YAML and Helm chart files are stored in a Git repository. This is very important. The code is automatically applied in the cluster. It's done with the tools like Flux or Argo that ensure to apply change by synchronization mechanism. The deployment lifecycle is then managed by regularly checking that there is no change in the repository. If there is a change, the cluster applies the change, simple as that. Several solutions are available to make this model. I choose to talk to you today about Flux2 because it is a very simple solution to implement and because version 2 should be really soon stable for production. This is the architecture. Flux is based on a set of Kubernetes API extension called custom resources, which consists of a control on how Git repositories and other sources of configuration are applied into the cluster. This is called synced. For example, you create a Git repository object to mirror configuration from a Git repository, then a customization object to sync that configuration. A source defines the origin of a source and the requirements to obtain it, for example, the version. For example, the latest 1xx tag available from a Git repository over SSH. Here is a basic example of a simple repository so that you understand the hierarchy. To deploy at least one application, like the PodInfo application here, we need two files. A file to declare the source of the deployment configuration, and another file to specify the deployment configuration for this cluster, called my cluster. Here are two examples of source management, including Helm and Customize. You can see here that we are controlling the source directly from a Helm or a Git repo. For example, we specify the repository URL as well as the time interval to control the change. Here, it's 1 minute. As you can see here, we have the PodInfo configuration setup in Customize, but also in Helm. It's just for the example. Now, here is the Helm configuration of our deployment. Please note that we can use values from the values YAML directly here to customize the chart. This is very powerful. It allows you to customize your chart directly in the repository. In this example, we set the replica to 2. We make the link with the source defined previously and ask Flux to check every 5 minutes if there are changes to apply. Flux provides also Prometheus exporters to easily integrate into a monitoring platform. You can see here how it looks using Grafana dashboards. It also allows you, to directly send notifications by Slack or by email if there are incidents or errors. Now let's take a common use case. In this example, the goal is to deploy 2 capsule clusters and configure them automatically. In each cluster, we will install Nginx Ingress with a Scaleway load balancer, self-manager, and Prometheus. We will install a Prometheus operator in the cluster. Prometheus operator include Prometheus, the node exporter, and other tools like Grafana or the push gateway. This is the architecture. As you can see here on the top, there are 2 Kubernetes capsule clusters, one in France and one in the Netherlands. As you can see, a repository on GitHub with the necessary codes to perform this configuration is managed by Git. Flux will check this Git repo automatically and apply the change on the cluster with his synchronization mechanism. So how we can do that? It's very easy. It can be done in 3 steps. First, you need to create the repo code on Git. This is very easy because if you speak YAML or Helm daily, it's very easy to write your code for Flux. It's basically the same code, but with a dedicated Flux object on Kubernetes. You have to use the custom CRD. After that, when the repo is up with the correct code deployed on it, you can deploy 2 capsule clusters. Your 2 capsule cluster. So the first one is in France, the second one in Netherlands. After the setup is finished, and when you have the 2 kubeconfig file to authenticate you on the cluster, you can deploy Flux. This is the final step. But how can you deploy Flux? It's just single line command. You can use Fluxctl, a powerful command line tools for Flux, that is basically the same that kubectl, but dedicated to Flux, to install Flux and manage all the operator and controller of Flux. So First, you have to create your repo code. Second, you need to create two capsule clusters, one in France, one in other region. And finally, you just have to set up Flux on this cluster with just a single I command. After that, it's done. Everything is set up automatically. The Nginx ingress controller with the dedicated load balancers, cert managers, and also Prometheus. So it's very easy to automate your Kubernetes configuration on Capsule. Thank you. Any questions?